Hello. The industry is talking a lot these days about augmented analytics as the new generation of analysis capabilities using predictive technology. When we think about augmented reality, it's quite natural to think about overlay images. For augmented analytics, it's not that easy to get a feel for it. So today, with ACP Analytics Cloud, I'd like to give you a concrete sense of what augmented analytics is, what it can do for you, how it can boost your analytical thinking. ACP Analytics Cloud was built from the ground up with augmented analytics in mind. For this, I'll use the College Scorecard dataset. The College Scorecard was created by the US government in 2015 under the Obama administration to help students decide which college made the most financial sense when considering tuitions, loans, grants, and future earnings. Calling it a scorecard is an understatement. What the US Department of Education is releasing is a dataset of epic proportion, and it's a beautiful raw material for data analysis. Gartner selected it for its BI Bake-Off contest both in 2016 and in 2019. The BI Bake-Off takes place during the Gartner Data and Analytics Summit. So here we see the College Scorecard dataset in ACP Analytics Cloud Data Preparation Interface. Before recording this video, I used it to prepare the dataset so that it can be analyzed. That's one thing that augmented analytics has in common with traditional analytics. It needs good data. The most important thing is to make sure that the dimensions and the measures are defined correctly. I also renamed columns from technical names with a more understandable description. And some dimensions that contain numeric codes, I replace those codes with the corresponding descriptions. The dataset is very well documented. So each row corresponds to a college, and it provides information on the college itself, like the numbers of students, the degrees awarded, the school revenue and expenditure, the tuition fees, the admission rates, the students' admission scores, the completion rate, its location, is it in a big city, a small city, in a suburb? It also provides info on the students, their age, their ethnicity, if they are financially dependent of their family, if they are part-time, are they first generation Americans? Do they come from a poor or a rich neighborhood? This is based on census data. Did they get a grant? Do they have loans? Repayment data, default rates, and of course, earnings after college. In total, hundreds of fields for thousands of colleges across the US. We'll focus our analysis on the former students' earnings 10 years after college entry. What are the key factors that will drive how much people will earn later on? So once we're happy with how the data looks like, we can get started with the analysis of students' earnings after college. This is where things get awkward. How to approach this, where to look, what to look for, what to focus on. We know we have hundreds of facts to consider. I already see myself slicing and dicing, comparing, trying to find patterns for countless hours in the hope of finding nuggets of information that later I can share, and praying that I don't miss anything crucial. That's what would happen in a traditional data discovery tool. Thankfully, with ACP Analytics Cloud, what we will experience will be radically different. Traditional data discovery is good for simple questions, closed-ended questions like, has the debt per student increased this year? But it falls short for more complex, open-ended questions. We'll see that actually the two approaches complement one another. Using them together in ACP Analytics Cloud will provide us terrific value. So here, what I did is launch a feature called Smart Discovery. We're going to start by leveraging the augmented BI capabilities. We could just go ahead, hit run, and ask ACP Analytics Cloud what is influencing earnings 10 years after college. But But before, we're going to exclude some measures that are obviously correlated with earnings 10 years after college and that we're not interested in. These are earnings 6, 7, 8 years after college, other stats on earnings, like the standard deviation. We are also excluding some facts on student loans, debt, facts on repayment, data on student default rate, and a bunch of other facts. We are also excluding some dimensions that are just not relevant. Behind the scene, SAP Analytics Cloud is building a machine learning regression model. We absolutely don't need to care about this. This is where the magic of SAP's unique automated predictive modeling technology is happening. On the first page, we see a distribution of earnings, but what we are the most interested in is on the second page. It provides the dimensions and the measures that have the most influence on future earning. This is what we are looking for. We see that the Carnegie classification is by far what has the most influence on future earnings. The share of students over 23 and the median family income are the second and third top influencers. I love this. SAP Analytics Cloud also tells us that the median family income itself is correlated with the average family income, no surprise here, and with the share of aided students coming from poor and wealthy families. This totally makes sense. Financial aid depends on family earnings. So let's look first at the Carnegie classification. We see that the top earnings correspond to doctorate universities and medical schools. Let's check to what colleges this corresponds to. The beauty of SAP Analytics Cloud, the beauty of augmented analytics, is that it sets our analysis, our questioning in motion. Here, we open the standard data exploration interface. We filter on doctorates and medical schools. Switch to a table, add the college name, replace the classification bin that was automatically generated by the source classification dimension, and sort on the highest earnings. We see that these are medical schools. If we filter on doctorate universities only, we see that these colleges are the MIT, Stanford, Harvard, Yale, Caltech, and the likes. We'll come back to this in the next video. We'll use augmented analytics to analyze earnings, excluding these very specific colleges. You'll see this will bring us a wealth of new findings. For now, let's continue to look at the factors that influence future earnings across all colleges. So the lower rate or higher rate of students over 23 has a positive influence. That probably reflects some subsegment of colleges, something we could explore as well. That's typical of data exploration. An answer leads to more questions. The higher the student's family income, the higher the earnings 10 years after college. That's unexpected and alarming. That means that it's not only the student's merits and degrees that determine future earnings. Students with a bachelor will earn more, that's expected and somewhat reassuring. Next is the college expenditure. Spending per student has a positive influence on earnings. That makes sense. The share of aided students from low family income has a negative impact on future earnings. In a traditional data discovery tool, you could easily conclude the more the students are aided, the less they are successful. That is just plain wrong. We just saw that the share of aided students is correlated with the family income. We are dealing here with a set of interdependent factors influencing future earnings. They need to be considered as a whole. They need to be considered together. AI is far superior to humans for this. Completion rate has a positive impact. That's expected. If you get your degree, you will earn more. Earnings is the highest for colleges where the share of women is around half, between 46 and 53%. What's intriguing here is that the greater the share of women is, the smaller the earnings. We definitely need to dig into that further. The next influencer is an interesting one as well. Historically, black colleges and universities, HCBUs, were established during segregation prior to the 1964 Civil Rights Act. At that time, most colleges in southern states prohibited African Americans from attending. So we see that students from HCBUs, from historically black colleges, tend to earn less after college. This is most likely related to another key influencer we found earlier, family income, because African American family income on average is lower. And finally, the family income of dependent students has also a strong influence on earnings. So that's the key takeaway so far, and somewhat unsettling. Out of the top 10 factors driving earnings 10 years after college, four are related to family income. In the next video, we'll deepen our exploration with stunning discoveries, I kid you not, and reap the full benefits of augmented analytics. See you there.